Hi everyone, in this video let us discuss about clonidine. Clonidine is one of the well-known drug which is classified as alpha receptor agonist. So these alpha 2 receptors are the adrenergic receptors. On these alpha 2 receptors, clonidine acts as agonist. So what is its effect on sympathetic activation? Even it acts as agonist, but it produces some negative effect on adrenergic neurons, so that it reduces the sympathetic activity. These alpha 2 receptors are present presynaptically within the CNS, where they control the sympathetic discharge. Now, by activation of these receptors, clonidine can reduce the sympathetic activity. And here, within the name of this drug, clo indicates having the chlorine groups, and the suffix nidine indicates it is having the imidazoline ring system. So, clonidine is a imidazoline derivative. So, today in this video, we are going to see what is the structure of this clonidine, how it acts, what are the important precautions, side effects, clinical indications, doses. All these things we will discuss in this video. So, what is the clinical indication of clonidine? The primary clinical indication of clonidine is as antihypertensive agent. Clonidine acts centrally to reduce the sympathetic discharge, thereby reduce the blood pressure. That's why it is a centrally acting antihypertensive agent. So, in order to treat hypertension, this drug can be given as a tablet form, or it can be given as patches. For emergency treatment such as hypertensive crisis, this clonidine can be given by intravenous route. Similarly, as an extended release tablet, this clonidine can be used for the treatment of ADHD, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, which is observed in the children with hyperactivity, aggressiveness, irritability, without any focus and attention and lack of concentration. So, in such conditions, clonidine can be given in order to reduce the irritability within the children. Similarly, clonidine can also be given by epidural route as an analgesic. Even it is not the main analgesic, it can be used as adjuvant along with opioids. So, clonidine can control the cancerous pain along with the opioids. So, these are the main clinical indications of clonidine. Apart from these, this drug can also be used to control the withdrawal symptoms of opioids, as well as if you have the anxiety disorders where sympathetic activation is increased. In such conditions, clonidine can be used. Now, let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So, this is the structure of clonidine. Here we can observe one of the heterocyclic ring system. This is nothing but imidazoline, which is partially saturated, and this imidazoline is attached with an amine group. So, let us give the numbering. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, amine group is attached at the second position, which can be written as 1H-imidazole-2-amine. Now, on the nitrogen of amine, phenyl ring is attached. So, we can write this as N-phenyl. To this phenyl, chlorine groups are attached at second and sixth position. So, 2,6-dichloro. So, clonidine is nothing but 2,6-dichlorophenyl substituted imidazoline derivative. And finally, saturation is present at 4th and 5th position of imidazoline. So, we can write it as 4,5-dihydro. That is the complete name of clonidine. Now, let us see how this drug acts. Just we have seen that clonidine acts on alpha 2 receptors as agonist. So, these alpha 2 receptors are present within the brain on adrenergic neurons. By activation of these inhibitory receptors, clonidine can reduce the sympathetic discharge, thereby it can reduce the blood pressure, as well as it can inhibit the release of excitatory neurotransmitters, resulting in increased sedation. Similarly, this drug can also act as agonist on alpha 2 receptors located at spinal cord. At the spinal cord, by activation of these alpha 2 receptors, clonidine can reduce the NMDA activation, thereby it can reduce the nociception. That's why it can be used along with the opioids to control the pain in cancer patients. So, suppose this is the adrenergic neuron which is stored with norepinephrine. Now, at the postsynaptic neurons, adrenergic receptors such as alpha or beta receptors are located. When this norepinephrine is released, it can act on these postsynaptic receptors to produce postsynaptic activation. In this way, sympathetic discharge is controlled by central nervous system. Now, these presynaptic neurons are equipped with alpha 2 receptors. These alpha 2 receptors are auto-inhibitory in nature. Clonidine acts as alpha 2 receptor agonist. It can bind to these receptors, resulting in their activation. Since these receptors are inhibitory in nature, they inhibit the activity of adenyl cyclase system, so that the ATP is somewhat less converted into cyclic AMP. So, in this way, cyclic AMP levels are reduced, which results in the inhibition of voltage-gated calcium channels. Now, calcium cannot enter easily through these channels because of decreased cyclic AMP levels. At the same time, the decreased cyclic AMP levels can stimulate the opening of potassium channels. Now, potassium can go outside, resulting in hyperpolarization. In this way, presynaptic neurons are inhibited so that norepinephrine is not released from the synaptic vesicles. Similarly, clonidine can also reduce the release of other mediators such as glutamate. By all of these, it can reduce the sympathetic activation as well as excitatory neurotransmission. Now, let us see the precautions of clonidine. We have seen that clonidine acts on the central nervous system, so it reduces the release of catecholamines from the CNS. These catecholamines generally act on heart so that they can produce cardiac contraction. Now, because of reduced sympathetic discharge, clonidine can reduce the cardiac contraction, resulting in bradycardia. Sometimes, with high dose of clonidine, we can observe some severe bradycardia as well as atrioventricular block. In such conditions, atropine can be given to counteract the bradycardia produced by clonidine. Similarly, due to the decreased sympathetic discharge, clonidine can produce the hypotension. That's why it is used as antihypertensive agent. But at high doses, it can produce severe hypotension, which should be closely monitored in the patients with any cardiovascular disorders. Similarly, clonidine can act on the brain such that it can reduce the excitatory neurotransmission. Thereby, it can produce some sedation in the patients, as well as it can also reduce the ventilation rate, resulting in respiratory depression. Particularly, these effects are more observed at high dose of clonidine. Another important precaution of clonidine is the withdrawal effects. When this drug is suddenly withdrawn, clonidine can produce various symptoms which are quite opposite to its pharmacological actions. So, this drug generally produces sedation, but when it is withdrawn suddenly, it can increase the nervousness in the patients, some agitation is increased, it can produce some headache, and even precipitate tremors within the patients. Since this drug reduces the blood pressure on sudden withdrawal, it can also increase the blood pressure. So, all these symptoms may be fatal within the patient. That's why this drug should not be suddenly withdrawn. The dose of the drug should be slowly escalated within 2 to 4 days in order to reduce these withdrawal effects. Similarly, this drug can produce some allergic reactions resulting in skin rashes, urticaria, and angioedema, resulting in swelling of lips, tongue, and larynx. So, if any such allergic reactions are developed, then clonidine is contraindicated. What are the side effects? The side effects of clonidine are mainly related with CNS inhibition. It can produce some somnolence, sleepiness in the patients, sedation. Similarly, it can produce dry mouth, constipation, upper respiratory tract infections such as nasal congestion, cough, rhinitis, sneezing. It can also produce some fatigue in the patients. Few of the patients can also observe some sore throat, ear pain, and nightmares with the use of clonidine. How it is given? This drug is given as a tablet form, which is available as normal tablet as well as extended release tablet. It is also available as solution, which is used for intravenous purpose as well as epidural injection. And this drug is also available as oral suspension as well as patches. So, in different dosage forms, clonidine is available. The dose of the drug depends on the type of clinical indication. For the treatment of hypertension, this drug is started at an initial dose of 0.1 mg given twice daily. So, it is given at morning as well as bedtime, and the dose is maintained within 0.2 to 0.6 mg per day in divided doses. When it is given as infusion for epidural purpose, the infusion rate may be started at 30 microgram per hour to control the pain in cancer patients. Similarly, in the treatment of ADHD, this drug is started at 0.1 mg, again given twice daily. So that's about this drug clonidine, which is a centrally acting antihypertensive, and it is classified as anti-adrenergic agent, but still it acts as agonist on alpha-2 adrenergic receptors. Since these receptors are auto-inhibitory in nature, clonidine can reduce the central sympathetic discharge, thereby it can reduce the blood pressure. It also reduces the NMDA activation and release of excitatory neurotransmitters so that it can produce some sedation, as well as it can reduce the hyperactivity within the children. It can also control the pain at the spinal cord level along with the opioids, so it can be used as analgesic in cancer patients. So that's about this drug clonidine. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.